Hello and welcome to Premier League predictions here on LiveScore. Sam, I've got a funny feeling that last week's predictions didn't go as well for any of us as we might have hoped.
No, absolutely not. When the best score is 5 out of 10, and by the way, that was I managed that, so okay. Very nice to extend my lead at the top of the table. But when the best score is 5, it hasn't gone well for any of us. But Dean, I heard him saying earlier that the scores were wrong.
It was an absolutely ridiculous game week. All the results did not turn out pretty much how they should have. Like, there's no predicting that. I mean, it's silly. Yeah. Like, Man City nil, Southampton nil. No, Man City won 1-0. Raheem Sterling scored. I saw it. That should have counted. West Ham 1, Man United 2. No, it would have been 2-2. You don't bring on someone to just take a penalty.
All right, buddy.
Like, I would have got both of those two right.
Yeah, you would have, yeah. But you did actually get just two right. So yes, on the whole weekend, like, Jack, you got three.
Oh, I've beaten Dean again. I'm clawing back this lead.
So the full table at the moment reads, myself top on 31, Dean on 23, Jack, you've moved up to 20.
I'm 11 points.
So get going.
All right. If I get all 11 right this week, then and you get none, then that'd be good.
Cool.
Considering there's 10 games, let's start with the first one. Chelsea, Man City. Sam, go on. Lead us off.
Oh, what a game. Mm. We start the weekend right, don't we?
A crackerjack.
Yeah. Pressure on City here, big time. I know they're at the wayside, but obviously dropping a few points here and there to start the season, and with Chelsea looking so good and so formidable, I feel like the pressure is genuinely really on them to get a result here. I can't bring myself to say they'll win it, though, but I don't think they're going to go into this game and end up losing it. So I'm going to go right in the middle, cowardice to start, and go for a draw.
Dean?
I doubted Tuchel before the Champions League final, and I said I don't think he can outwit Pep again, and I was wrong. So I think he is going to outwit Pep this time. Remember what he did last time when he squeezed the play and he was trying to force Man City to go long. Does that again, then, well, I think we're looking at a 1-0 Chelsea win.
Chelsea feel invincible, don't they, at the moment? It's a strange one because I think that pressure will actually suit City. Okay. I actually think that this is where their season kicks into gear. I'm going with a City win. So let's mix and match it. Let's see if that Chelsea juggernaut is invincible indeed. Man United, Aston Villa, Dean.
Man United, so inconsistent, so difficult to predict.
Not in this fixture, though.
Not in this fixture. And they've got Cristiano Ronaldo as well. So I think that's, to be honest, a straightforward Man United win.
Yeah, it feels like it, doesn't it?
United, I think, have got a complete dominance in this fixture. Villa have won one of the last 45 league meetings between the sides. Last win at Old Trafford 2009. Long time ago. United win.
Hmm. This is a game I remember for Fede Makeda.
Of course, yeah. One thing that he did.
Well, I think it's going to be a similar story, similar outcome this weekend. So I'm going to join you with a United win, which takes us to the first of the 3 o'clock on Saturday, Leicester-Burnley. I'll start us off with a Leicester win. It's just, it feels like Burnley's slow start trickles along.
Yeah. Do you remember last week when I said, when does the start end?
And
it wasn't
game
week 5.
We're going to continue that
it's not game week 6
either.
The
start hasn't ended yet.
Okay. No. The start continues.
And Burnley therefore lose.
Okay. I'm with you.
Yeah?
Yeah.
With you.
100%.
Dean?
Leicester haven't been beaten by Burnley at home since 2007. And Burnley, even when they do go ahead in games, they find a way to throw it away. So I've got no faith in them here. It's Leicester win.
Leicester need a shot in the arm as well.
They do.
With a
this is the perfect team to play.
It feels like it. Everton, Norwich, talking of needing a pick-me-up. Everton got a bit of a battering last week off Villa. And this seems like the team you'd want to play at home next.
Definitely, yeah. I mean, Everton have got their absences, they've got their issues. Obviously, last week they didn't have Richarlison, didn't have Dominic Calvert-Lewin, didn't have Pickford. We'll see how the injuries clear up, but you can't shake the feeling that even if they actually end up with neither of those or none of those three for this game, they still win. Norwich have been dreadful, haven't they? Mm. I think this is kind of easy for me to call.
Yeah.
I'm a bit scared because I said Everton would beat Aston Villa last week and they lost 3-0, which is ridiculous. I reckon they win 3-0.
Yeah, I agree. It's three clean sweeps in a row. It feels difficult to see where a Norwich win is going to come from right now, doesn't it? Like, last week against Watford felt like, at home, a fellow newly promoted side felt like the best opportunity to pick up some points and still wasn't great from a Norwich perspective. It doesn't look pretty.
They were awful.
Midweek League Cup game. Maybe bounce back in morale. No, lose that. Get stuffed.
It's not.
To be fair, that was against Liverpool.
I know, it doesn't help, does it?
It doesn't help. It just seems doom on gloom for Norwich again. Which takes us to Leeds United against West Ham United, which is probably, I think, the pick of the 3 o'clock kickoffs, if it was me.
It's not a bad game, is it, this one? Didn't think I'd be in a situation where I just feel so confident in the idea that West Ham can go and win this one. Leeds have had a really dodgy start to the season. They've got a lot of injuries and problems piling up, particularly, you know, they've been playing with midfielders at centre-back and youth prospects at centre-back. They've got no midfield to speak of anyway. It's been really tough for them. And with Mikel Antonio back in the fold and with a big win in midweek in the cup against Man United, I like West Ham here.
Mm. I think West Ham are having a great season. I really enjoy watching them. Leeds struggling to fill their bench, really. They're having to put under 23 players on there. There's just been nothing for me to have any faith in them so far, so I have to go West Ham win.
It's hard to write Bielsa's sides off, obviously, but at the moment, given that Strike's out, given that Robin Koch is out, given that Diego Llorente is out, we saw in midweek in the Cup, it was Charlie Cresswell and Calvin Phillips at centre-back. One of those is a 19-year-old academy graduate, and the other one is a centre midfielder. It doesn't look great for Leeds at the moment. I think they'll be fine. I think they'll bounce back.
Yeah,
I think
course.
Once
yeah,
the injury crisis well. Clears up. But at the moment, it feels like, well, especially with this West Ham attack in full flow at the moment, they're not going to be able to keep them out. West Ham win. Leeds win, yeah. Watford, Newcastle.
Still not comfortable predicting Newcastle to do well.
So?
They're not very good, are they?
No.
Watford win.
Watford win?
Watford
Dean?
Win.
Yeah, I like Watford. I like watching Watford. I don't like watching Newcastle, so I'm going to go with Watford.
No, that's fair enough. I still think the Leeds are a better side than Watford, and Newcastle picked up a point against Leeds last week, so I'm going to go draw.
Okay.
I'm going to go for a draw.
It was good
one.
To get some variety, because we've been going
down
the same
There was a lot of sweeps here. I was aware of it, and I imagine there's going to be a sweep in the next one too, so it's likely to, you know, it feels right to mix it up a little bit. Yeah, I genuinely think Newcastle, they've been relatively... They haven't been good by any stretch of the imagination, and they don't inspire, but they are fighting relatively hard. And that in itself is enough, I think, to probably steal a point here. So
okay.
I can go with that. Brentford, Liverpool. Dean?
I don't even know what to say. Liverpool. That's all I can say. Brentford surprised me a couple of times already this season, but this is Liverpool, so I can't even begin to... put up an argument, to be honest.
Look, Brentford have had a really good start to the
season.
They've
been really impressive.
They've got a good partnership up front with Tony and Mbeumo. They've been defensively super solid. Every week we sit here and say they've got the second best expected goals against tally, just second only to Manchester City. They continue to stop teams from really creating high quality chances. But when was the last time they played a team anything like Liverpool? Like in the last 3 decades. They've been in the Championship for a long, down in the lower leagues for a long time. They haven't faced a test like this in the Premier League, and Liverpool keep winning 3-0.
They do it every week.
So it's going to be 3-0 again.
Well, I've predicted Brentford to lose 3-0 the last 3 weeks, and they haven't. So I'm going to just go with a Liverpool win quietly and just go about my business, because I think that's the right thing to do. But Brentford have impressed, and that win over Wolves last week, I think, shocked a lot of people. It was a very good away win for Brentford. Southampton versus Wolves, first game on Sunday. Thoughts?
Southampton hate this one. They've won one of the last 10 in the league against Wolves in different divisions, but obviously in the last 3 or 4 years.
They also
hate
playing Man City, and last week they got a point against them.
Exactly. So where does that leave us? I genuinely don't know. I find this one of the toughest ones to call. Been super impressed with Southampton recently in terms of defensive solidity. I did not know they had it in them. Wolves are a total enigma. They can either play really well and lose, or play not that great and win. I kind of feel myself drifting down the middle here, but I want to be a bit bolder. I'm going to go for the home win for Saints.
Okay, Dean?
Yeah, I am too. It does feel a bit like toss a coin here, because you don't know what you're getting from either team, but I've just got a bit more faith in Southampton, and their performances against Man City and Newcastle were good. So, yeah, going Southampton win.
I'm
going
to go with the draw. I think Wolves are still yet to, you know, fully explode, and they feel like they're playing within themselves a little bit, and I don't know how much of that is down to how much Raul is able to be involved.
He's very frustrated,
yeah,
isn't he?
Yeah, it feels a little bit odd, and I think that at some point Bruno Lage is going to have to make a very, very difficult decision.
I think it should be this weekend. I really do.
But I think Wolves will have enough to get a point here. Southampton have been really, really impressive, and I've thought they're excellent. But I think Wolves need something to ignite their season.
Yep.
I think a point here will help.
This would be Southampton's first win of the season. Like, they still haven't won a game. They've been pretty good, but they're yet to get that 3-point haul. So I guess me and Dean are sticking our necks out and saying this is it.
Okay. North London derby, Arsenal-Tottenham, 4:30 on Sunday. Where do you see it going? Well, we know what Dean's going to say.
Well, Tottenham don't like London derbies, we've learned in the last couple of weeks. Crystal Palace and Chelsea, they lost both of them 3-0. So I guess they'll take some confidence in the fact that Arsenal aren't that good themselves, but they did win 3-0 in midweek. And They're slowly taking positive steps. I do think it's really hard to call. You're looking for one moment probably to separate them. I really don't think there's a lot in between these teams right now. But Tottenham really do not have a good record at Arsenal. They've only won one in the last 28 away from home in this fixture. So I can't put any faith in them right now. I'm going to go draw.
Sam?
Yeah, me too. I'm gonna
have
say
you two made a separate prediction yet? You've just gone the whole way. You're either getting 10 or not.
We meet before, decide it all, and then tell you about it.
Yeah. This has got, for some reason, I'm feeling a 0-0 here.
Okay.
It's just going to be a real letdown. Two clubs that are very nervous, two teams that are very nervous and haven't really been that good creatively recently in the last couple of weeks. You know, Arsenal winning a couple of games 1-0 doesn't really, it's good to get the points on the board, but you've got to sort of temper the expectations there. And Spurs have been pretty dreadful for the last couple of weeks.
Yeah.
So I'm going to go for the draw as well.
I'm going to go bacon. The baby steps continue for Arsenal. I'm going to go with a home win. I think that maybe it just feels like they're on a slightly more positive feel at the moment. They are just sort of, as you say, slowly moving in the right direction. Things are starting to click. The team is starting to come back together from that injury crisis. It just feels like everything's a wee bit more settled at Arsenal than it was a couple of weeks back. I think this could be a big moment in their season.
I mean, look, if Tottenham lose again, and that's the third successive league defeat, then we're talking about a mini crisis themselves there, and Nuno with a lot to prove.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Which takes us to our last one, another derby. Well, a rivalry, shall we say. Crystal Palace against Brighton. The M23 derby, I believe it's known
as. What a strange game.
It is a strange game. A rivalry born out of the 1970s. It's at Crystal Palace. It's at Selhurst. What would you reckon, Dean?
I reckon you're right. They do hate each other, so they'll be
they
a good
really
atmosphere.
Don't like each other,
they
do they?
Really
that's
do.
What the, I think maybe the more recent rivalry element of this has actually made it much more fiery.
Yeah, it's better than most actual derbies, so don't miss it. Who do I fancy? Probably Brighton, to be honest. I think Brighton edge this.
Sam?
I'll go Palace because you've accused us of collusion. So, Palace.
Okay.
They've actually got a really good recent record in this. They haven't lost any of the last four. I think they've won two, drawn two. So, and they've got good home form. They haven't conceded a goal
yet. But Graham Potter's the new Guardiola, so...
Brighton have been really impressive. I think the weird thing about this is we just don't know how good Palace are.
No.
Like, there's no idea that everything... It seems to be moving in the right direction, then obviously they have to go and play Liverpool. It's very difficult to actually get a vibe of how good Palace are.
I don't know how good either of these
sides are. They started quite well.
Honest.
I think Brighton are quite good, but I'm not sure where Palace are yet.
Yeah.
I'm going to, well, complete the set, go for the draw.
Hey, well done, mate.
There we are. Just in the last
top and tail
one.
It.
Top and tail it. We'll complete the set on very the top good. And the bottom. Right, that's all our predictions for this week on LiveScore. We'll be back next week to see, how Dean and Sam got on together and how I got on apart from that. We'll see you then. Take care.